Welcome to an analysis of our water and wastewater chemicals world markets report. This is Bob McElvain talking about a report that's about 4,000 to 5,000 pages long. It's updated continually. There are updates every week. In fact, probably daily there are things being changed to it. It's online. It sounds overwhelming, but on the other hand, it's very user-friendly, so you can get the information that you need very quickly. Let's, for instance, look at the updates, and you'll see that you can go in by month, and it has financial information and other things about what's going on in the marketplace and investments and et cetera. Now, that contrasts to the updates we have in each industry. So you can actually go into the industry analysis in an industry, and we do this monthly as well, and you can see the updates for May in the chemicals industry alone, and you can see BASF is going to be building a new plant, Dow's opening a new plant, and so forth. So by industry, whether it's municipal wastewater, steel, chemicals, oil and gas, we do have that kind of information as well. So the updates are very substantial each month. Let's maybe even just go to another one or two to give you the idea here. We'll get out of these chemical updates. And we can go on to one of the others. Let's take oil and gas, for instance. And again, we'll go to the industry analysis. The generic would give you information on the use of the chemicals in the industry. And then, but again, here would be the updates. And so you're talking about the May updates, and these are just the May updates with projects just for the oil and gas industry. So you can see that this is useful for your salespeople as well as for your top management. You know, you're not only getting the global forecast, but you're getting pretty detailed information. So you can, let's just click onto another one. For instance, we'll go down to the refinery industry, and you, of course, get the updates and things as well there. But you can also go into the plant databases, and you can search by facility name. You can search by any one of these approaches there. And then you can click on these refineries and at least get the, that's a, not a good one, and click on details here by the individual refinery itself. There, in a place like this, there's quite a few different ones to try to hit the actual at Beaumont. Actually, one with some of the information that I was looking for here. But in any case, there is quite a bit of information on the individual companies that is all part of this as well. And you even got refinery profiles by refinery headquarters and other information where you can go into these things this way and look at SR oil and gas and so forth here. So this is another way of looking at it, but it's all within the water and wastewater report. Now across the top you have the forecasting, and the forecasting is also something where the individual salesman can participate because we have this information down to by type of chemical, by industry, and then by country. So if he is selling to the mining industry, let's say, or the refining industry, and he is your salesman in China, and you can then click and he can look and see what we have by industry, by subject, and so forth. But we can click by China since we're already into industries. Now, this is what we predict for corrosion inhibitors in the refining industry, ion exchange, organic flocculants, scale inhibitors, and so forth in the refinery industry in China in 2011. So this allows your salesperson in that area to have some feedback and for you to also provide quotas and things for him. So this can be taken to the next level, which is instead of just being a strategic market report, can be a working document going both directions between the sales person trying to orient his schedule and top management that's evaluating what he's doing. So the company analysis is another feature of this, and you can actually go into company sales rankings by 2009, for instance, and see, have to blow that up a little bit here, some of the major companies and what their market shares are geographically and by types of chemicals. So that is another aspect of the report that's worked from the top here. Now, another thing would be the networking directory. And you can view all companies where, and they're huge, all the companies in this business, there are 10 different pages of them looking that way. But you can go search by a particular company too, and you can go in that direction. So you can go in by Nalco and see people at those locations around the universe. The other way is to go in by country, and you can see the people that appear within a particular company that are chemical manufacturers. So the networking directory is another good way to go. Now, we do have a lot of other really valuable information for the North America. We do have a chemical bid review, so you can actually go in for wastewater. You can go in by activated carbon and see current bids and bid reviews. So here's a bid review for this particular plant and for all these different products here. And if you actually go in then for those products, it gives you the results of who bid what and how much was bid by and who the successful bidders are. So we have that kind of information that's right in the market report. So that gets to be pretty granular information. And that can be looked at another way, too. You can go in, rather than by chemical report, by contract dates. So you can actually see if this was 311 through 312, well, then next year around January, you better be contacting this particular Peace River plant, because about that time, its annual contract will be up, and it'll be time for a new one. We have a lot of really good information on these various different industries as well. And you can go in and, for instance, the whole website we have on the cosmetics industry and the use of chemicals in that industry and what how that industry is structured. So that is things that you're looking at there, revenues and so forth there of the various different technologies that are included in individual company data for people that are systems integrators and so forth in this area. The we do have various different audio and video recordings too with the various people making various chemicals. So you can go into Hot Topic recordings and see the people that are in shale gas quality, boiler and cooling water treatment, and listen to some of their presentations by these people as well, talking to GE, to Tony Rossi, for instance, of GE, talking about various different things. And then you can down and actually click on the PDF or listen to the whole presentation. So here you're just looking at the PDF itself and explaining some of the information. So there's a lot of technical data that's in the report, as well as good forecast data for every country of the world. And we would look forward to answering any additional questions that you might have about this very comprehensive report, which is updated continually. You can talk to Denise Flesh at our company. You can also talk to myself, and this is Bob McElvain. you can reach either one of us at 847-784-0012 and also talk to a number of the other people, including Tom Shantz. And Tom is the editor of this publication and has been with us several years. He is formerly with IDEX, vice president of IDEX, and now with us. So any of us would be looking forward to talking to you about this report and some of the related services. And this will end the presentation today. Thank you.